back to another Siege video. In today's Siege, we are versus Aftermath Unleashed, who I've never played against before, but looking at their squad, they've got some really good experienced players, so it should be interesting. And Doubt Habibi, who has a couple of our old members in, should be interesting. The only worry in here is last time we played Habibi, they all did us on day one and kind of ruined the Siege, so yeah, hopefully. Hopefully this is a better match and we're not all in on day one. In terms of form, we are looking dreadful. We had like 16 sieges where we dropped 2 attacks. And then in the last 5, I've dropped 5. So yeah, not good. Quite a lot of wrong teams. But then last siege, we had the nightmare of the huge misplay in game when I didn't use the S2 from Miyang. Lack of concentration. Maybe doing it at work wasn't so good, but... Yeah, and then there was the bad RNG on the rerun where the DMR's revenged, and then, yeah, everything just didn't really go well. It could have possibly put that down to maybe he's the wrong team or something, I don't know. So that's pretty much it. So we'll just get straight into the games. This is the third last siege of the season, so, yeah, everything counts now. We need to get wins, and everyone, including not just us, everyone's looking to try and secure tournament places. So yeah, let's get straight into the games. So for the first attack, we were versus the Kiki, Byungi, whatever he's called, the Windogger, and Perna. Starting to see quite a bit of the Windogger on defense, and he's pretty cool. He's quite annoying. We went with our Tiana, Asima, Verad team. So strip into AoE defense, break into pushback, and then just try and get it over the line with follow-up damage.
I know that you like that, you know where my mind's at. Can't be tamed, I'm not gonna play, not gonna play. Oh no, I ain't like that, fucking mama wildcat. Baby, break my heart, give it all you got. Don't ask why.
For the second attack, we were versus the Sierra, Gianna, and Masha team. It was a kind of an old random LD team. Basically, we used the Light Lich to tank up the Sierra and the Gianna, obviously with a passive. It's pretty hard for the Lich to die. We just make him really tanky. Then we have the Miho Wang and Rakuni on minus fire to make sure that Masha can't proc and kill us in the opener. And then we simply just kill him down while the Light Lich tanks.
Don't be shy, shy, shy.
For the next attack, we were versus the Clara, Chillin, and Usha defense, which has been popular this season. Here we're going to use the Dark Elven Ranger, Isilin, I think it's pronounced, with Rakuni and Tetra. Basically, they open up and put a lot of pressure out, but then we've got two high sustain units in Rakuni and Tetra who will pick up whoever's low. As long as we don't like get all in on the turn one with a defense break landed on the Dark Elven Ranger, and them all proccing a lot, we should be in a good position, and we should start to slowly let them kill themselves as they hit us.
Don't be shy, shy, shy.
Don't get hurt, can't feel anything. When will I learn? I push it down, push it down. I'm the one for a good time. Call phones blowing up, the ring of my doorbell. I feel the love, feel the love. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. Coming back tonight, let's count.
So for the next attack, we were versus the Harmonia, Viger, and Kinky defense. We've played this quite a bit as we ran into the Russian Guild Joker quite a bit, and they just run this all season round. We opted to use the Tractor, Windy, and Tetra on double destroy rather than a revenge set on Tractor, and just higher damage, and we just tunnel damage into the Viger and win the destroy war. From there, we just kill the Harmonia and kill the Kinky.
Don't get hurt, can't feel anything. When will I learn? I push it down, push it down. I'm the one for a good time. Call phones blowing up, the ring of my doorbell. I feel the love, feel the love. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. Coming back tonight, let's count.
For the next attack, we were again versus the Harmonia, Viger, Kinky, and this time we actually managed to lose, and basically we just got overrun with damage. I think the Harmonia proc'd a bit more than the other time, but it came down to the fact that I should have used a Lulu. Don't know why I was using the Tetra, just common for me nowadays just to use the Tetra over the Lulu, but the Lulu was the better pick here. It just had more healing output. So we ended up losing just because, yeah, they put too much damage out, and they just like spread damage across the board, and they eventually ended up killing us. But yeah, pretty much just the wrong sustain unit used here. So yeah, it's something to learn myself, but annoying because we just keep picking up these one losses. But yeah, let's just watch it.
You lift your ugly sweater so that I can forget you. I'm so fed up when you're around, round, round, round. And when I'm feeling better, you always find a way to get in my head and bring me down, down, down. I tried and tried and tried, but I can't let go. So come set me free. I'm down feeling blue. I'm falling apart, a faded love. I'm counting to three. I hear the alarm. I'm falling apart, a faded love. Three.
tried and tried and tried, but I can't let go. So come set me free. I'm done feeling blue. I'm falling apart, a faded love. I'm counting to three. I hear the alarm. I'm falling apart, a faded love.
Next attack, we were versus the Kiki, Lumai, and Molly, and we used our Praline Sonya Eleanor, which gives obviously a double Sonya nuke. I'm always a bit wary about this in case it's some kind of like crazy double defense trap, but yeah, basically we just snipe the Molly and then we snipe the Kiki, leaving a 3-1.
Tired of being what you want me to be, feeling so faithless, lost under the surface. You don't know what you're expecting of me, put under the pressure of walking in your shoes. Caught in the undertow, just caught in the undertow. And every step that I take is another mistake to you.
For the next attack, we versus the Clara, Chillin, and Vitra defense. I tried this for the first time. I tried the Dark Elven Knight with the double cleanse. It kind of worked, but it was a lot more worse. I don't know if they just proc'd more, or if this is just a lot worse than the Usher version. But obviously, it has an extra defense break, so in general, yeah, I don't think I'd use this again. It worked, but with the having an extra defense break and then that being a dark unit, the threat and damage output seemed a lot higher. So yeah, it worked this time, but definitely something I won't be trying again.
Oh,
But yeah, for the next attack, we were back versus the Harmonia Viga Kinky, and this time we used the correct sustain. We used the Lulu, which gives us the higher healing output, and yet we just destroy the Viga down and kill him, and this one goes a lot more smoother. So yeah, let's just watch it. Next attack, we were back versus the Kiki, Windoga, and Perna, and this time we're going to use our Maxi Tiana, and we're going to use the Firetress. The Firetress has AoE pushback and damage. I actually quite like the Firetress, but every tier list is such as the tend to score a low, but for me, I think she's pretty unique in that she is the only fire unit that can push back AoE unconditionally. So yeah, so basically the idea is we just strip him up, maxi moves, defense breaks, puts all his debuffs up, then Firetress comes, she nukes and pushes everything back, and then Maxi, Tiana follow up, and then Firetress can try and stun defense break with S2. Don't know how you get by one day, you'll say, I'm sorry, you never had to worry, I'm changing up the story. The final attack, we were versus the Kiki, Molly, and Byungi, the Wind Ogre, and we used our Amelia, Bulwark, and Molon combo. We just sniped up the Kiki, turn one, and then from there, it's pretty hard to lose a 3-2, I feel. The Wind Ogre has decent damage, but it's not massively bursty without a defense break, so yeah, we just snipe up Kiki, and then should be free win.
Memorize, 'cause still I fantasize of every moment
Yep, so this is the final standings. We've finished in first place, AF Unleashed finished in second, and Doubt Habibi finished in third. The game was actually really, really close. Like, at one point I was really worried we were going to get, like, dumped on and finish in, like, second or third, but we did have a decent win rate advantage, but it was, regardless of that, it was still quite close to, like, the final sort of 100 attacks, swords left. Yeah, and then, like, the other two guilds started to play, fight it out for a second, so I was quite glad when that happened, because I just thought, like, if Doubt Habibi just all in us randomly, then it might affect the those we're trying to finish first. But yeah, overall, close siege, pretty ended pretty fair, I think. I think the result of us first, AF second, and Doubt Habibi third was justified by the win rate. We finished 9-1, obviously upset with the 1, but yeah, that's becoming the norm at the minute, so I need to try and get out of that. Wasn't a very, even the others, it was still a little bit of, feel like it wasn't great. Defenses-wise, it was good. We got 6 wins, 4 on the Nasha one, and 2 on the Sylvia Audrey, which I'm happy with. The Shazam one got dumped on, and we didn't really use the Misty one. So yeah, not too bad. Pretty happy with obviously winning, because now puts us in a good position for the last two sieges and potentially making the tournament. I'm not going to do an update on the global account because we're still halfway through using our swords for this siege. I'll probably just capture that in next video. But yeah, cheers for watching, and good luck to anyone trying to push for the tournament. Yep, cheers, bye.